people who have been colonized or occupied have an experience of their occupier romancing their culture, and this is what this poem is about.
Yes.
Our bodies, our culture, its colors and noises are too often taken by those self-anointed, these men who hear God, king, and country telling us to pillage and plunder their bodies, their culture, their colors and noises, men with delusions of discovery, convinced that grave robbing is a discipline, that there is somehow a difference between their museums and mausoleums, as if Olmec heads and Mayan hieroglyphs don't feel like tombstones in their galleries. This is a type of appropriation akin to autopsy and dissection. All rock hammer fingertips, spade shovel palms dig us out by the root and take all that shines around and beneath us and call it scholarship. Name it anthro, archaeo, or some other ology that places us in the categories to find us as a people once capable of greatness. Prop up our oldest bones, say nothing when they put down our living bodies. Restore our oldest text, but ban our relevant curriculum, because they have got it covered. They will teach you about yourself in passing moments in the form of documentary specials and fleeting exhibitions of a people conquered and displaced. Make it look magnificent, make it feel so grand, so untouched by the bloody hands of the past. Make you pay $14 admission to walk through halls adorned in this country's obsession with the dead parts of yours. These installations, these necrophilic obsessions feel like the only way they would ever think us beautiful, to believe us to be worthy of preservation, deserving of glass cases in the eyes of night watchmen. These stories, these exhibits read like eulogies for a people that no longer are, as if I am not right here, living as memorial, as if these types of displays are of ancestors without descendants, as if we are without her right now and will only have back then. These are tactics of erasure, the way they see you then and not now. See you wartime trophy, see you spoils of conquest, see you broken and romantic like bits and pieces of Machu Picchu or remains of American tribes stirred from their rest, hoisted in the hands of cranes, scrutinized in the eyes of scholars, chemically treated and prepped for presentation. Our bodies, our culture, its colors and noises are all things I will not pay an admission price to mourn again.